Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In a city called Harasta, which is located in Damascus in Syria, a mujahid by the name of Al-Hassan ibn Farqad made preparations to move his home with his wife. And so they traveled to Iraq and settled in the city of Wasit. It was now the year 131 after Hijrah, and Allah granted this couple a son, and he was named Muhammad. Shortly after his birth, the family once again moved home. This time, the place they settled in was Kufa, the home of Imam Abu Hanifa Rahimahullah. The boy born to this couple grew up to become Imam Muhammad ibn al-Hassan Ash-Shaybaani Rahimahullah, the second most famous student of Imam Abu Hanifa Rahimahullah. What is remarkable about Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah is the fact that he only spent 2 years studying under Imam Abu Hanifa Rahimahullah before Imam Abu Hanifa passed away. He then completed his studies under Imam Abu Yusuf Rahimahullah that had taken over after Imam Abu Hanifa Rahimahullah. You may think that this was only just 2 years, but 2 years in the right hands can be used to do a great many things. In this regard, Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah was akin to Hazrat Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, who only spent roughly 2 years and 3 months with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But despite that, he is the most prolific narrator of ahadith. So much he had engrossed himself in memorizing all the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now, such was the case with Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah, that despite spending so little time with Imam Abu Hanifa Rahimahullah, he was untouched in his brilliance, as he not only absorbed the knowledge of Imam Abu Hanifa, but he fully comprehended it too at that young age. That is why he is known as the student of Imam Abu Hanifa Rahimahullah, because by the time he began studying under Imam Abu Yusuf Rahimahullah, he was already a shining star. Besides having studied under both Imam Abu Hanifa and Imam Abu Yusuf, Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah also studied under many of the great luminaries of the time, such as Imam Malik ibn Anas Rahimahullah. Imam Muhammad studied for just over 3 years under Imam Malik, and thus became one of the many students to transmit the Muwatta of Imam Malik Rahimahullah. However, the version compiled by Imam Muhammad had a slight twist to the actual Muwatta of Imam Malik, because in the version authored by Imam Muhammad, after narrating a hadith, he would add on a short commentary from a Hanafi fiqh perspective. Thus, this kitab came to be known as the Muwatta of Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah instead. Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah attained a high rank amongst the fuqaha at a very young age. As a result, he began to teach in Kufa while he was still in his early 20s. And in those days, you didn't just teach because you felt like it. Rather, in order for you to be able to teach, you would have had to have received the recognition of the fuqaha of the time that you are a faqih that is capable of teaching the deen. And this is what the ulama felt about Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah at that young age. Having completed his studies under Imam Abu Yusuf, Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah now became the central pillar of the Hanafi madhab, and he began writing kitabs, expounding and explaining the deen for future generations, through the understanding of Imam Abu Hanifa and Imam Abu Yusuf Rahimahumallah. And by virtue of this, the Hanafi madhab in its truest essence was now preserved, and these books of Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah are used up until this very day, which is more than 1200 years ago. It is a tough choice to say which kitab of Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah is his most famous one, because all of his kitabs are equally as famous. The name of the main book of fiqh which was written by Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah is known as Al-Asl, but it's famously known, or better known, as Al-Mabsut. And it is this Mabsut which has been tirelessly been referenced and referred to by the ulama throughout the ages as the most authoritative book written on the Hanafi madhab. And this is a perfect example of the strength of following a madhab, because you are linking yourself to a firm and unbroken chain that authentically goes back all the way to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, while those who abandon the madhahib end up floundering around without any anchor. Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah was initially appointed as the Qadi of Raqqah in Syria during the time when Imam Abu Yusuf Rahimahullah was the Qadi al-Qudah. But later on, he returned to Baghdad and resumed his teaching of his classes over there. At this point in time, Imam Ash-Shafi'i Rahimahullah was still starting out in his studies, and he came to study under Imam Muhammad Rahimahullah. In this way, the Hanafi madhab played an influencing role in the lives of the A'imma of both the Hanbali and the Shafi'i madhabs, with Imam Ahmad studying under Imam Abu Yusuf and Imam Ash-Shafi'i studying under Imam Muhammad rahimahumullah. That is why Imam Ash-Shafi'i rahimahullah had the utmost respect and admiration for Imam Muhammad, and Imam Ahmad had only the highest praise for Imam Abu Yusuf rahimahumullah, all of which stemmed from the fountainhead of knowledge that was Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. Much like Imam Abu Yusuf's Kitab al-Kharaj that became a source for the Islamic State, so too was Imam Muhammad's Kitab As-Siyar As-Saghir as well as As-Siyar Al-Kabir. These books dealt with the laws of jihad and treaties and the expansion of the Islamic State and international law. And these books became the foundation upon which the Islamic States functioned. And it is upon this basis that the later ulama based all of their works as well. After this period of time of teaching in Baghdad and the passing away of the great Imam Abu Yusuf rahimahullah, the Khalifa Harun al-Rashid approached Imam Muhammad rahimahullah once again, and this time he appointed him in the position of Imam Abu Yusuf as the new Qadi al-Qudha. So the first two people to ever hold the title of Qadi al-Qudha in the Islamic world was Imam Abu Yusuf and Imam Muhammad rahimahumallah. It was while serving as the Qadi al-Qudha that Imam Muhammad rahimahullah accompanied Harun al-Rashid to Khurasan, and it was when they arrived in the city of Ray that Imam Muhammad rahimahullah passed away in the year 189 at the age of only 58 years old. Imam Muhammad rahimahullah didn't live to a very old age, but in those 58 short years that he lived on this earth, he left behind an imprint that has lasted for over 1,000 years. May Allah allow us to travel the path these ulama took, so that our lives can be spent doing fruitful things that will be a means of benefit for us in this world and the hereafter. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen, wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.